If you're a homeowner or hobbyist, this is probably a familiar sight. A whole bunch of sockets from a whole bunch of socket sets you've bought over the years. And why did we buy so many socket sets? Because in this pile of sockets, and this is not all of them, believe you me, there's not a single 7/16 inch socket. That's the size you use for tightening down a standard 1/4 inch bolt. Because the one you use is the first you lose. So if you've lost a socket from your set, you should maybe try printing a replacement for it with your 3D printer. Stick around and see how you can print a whole bunch of different sockets and learn why Printable Science loves these things. Printable Science presents a 3D printed socket set. Socket sets aren't all that expensive, but they're not that cheap either. You can buy a single replacement socket, but the price is typically insane. Usually a single socket will cost you about the quarter of an entire set. So we've crafted our own sockets. Because paying pennies for a replacement makes a lot more sense than shelling out a few dollars. Now, as you probably know, there's a number of different variations between sockets. The first is the size of the socket itself. And you can use the socket that fits over the nut or head of the bolt you want to fasten. So for example, if you're tightening down a 1/4 inch bolt, you'd use a 7/16 inch socket because that's what fits the head. You'll note that sockets also vary depending on the number of edges around at the lip. There's the standard six-sided hexagonal shape that conforms to the shape of a nut or bolt head. But there's also 12-sided ends, which are popular too, as some people find it easier to use those to find purchase on the bolt or nut they're trying to tighten when there's twice as many ways in which the socket will fit over it properly. There's also 4-sided and the related 8-sided octagon sockets for square nuts and bolt heads. Then there's the depth of the socket. The standard or shallow socket gives you a 1/2 inch of clearance, but there are two other standard depths as well, the deep socket that gives you 1 inch of clearance and the medium-sized socket that gives you 3/4 inch of clearance. And finally, there's a choice of size on the other end of the socket that fits your ratchet or drive handle. The standard sizes are 1/4, 3/8, and 1/2 inch sizes. The files we've included for this video include standard hexagonal shallow sockets for all the socket sizes from 1/4 inch through 1/2 inch in 32nd inch increments to fit all 3 drive and ratchet handles. And if you're one of our Patreon supporters, you should check out our page on Patreon and learn how you can get a hold of files to print sockets in just about any size and configuration you like. Change the size, go for metric, change the gripping pattern, depth of socket, you name it. Now, if you print these sockets on an FDM printer out of PLA or ABS, you're not going to be using it to assemble a bridge truss, but you'd be surprised how strong these sockets are and how well they hold up under repeated use. And given the price differential, you can go through a whole bunch of 3D printed sockets before you even get close to the price of a commercially manufactured metal replacement. And hey, maybe you've got a 3D printer that prints metal. Okay, maybe not. We can all dream. We printed our socket set in PLA with a 0.2 millimeter layer height, 2 bottom and 3 top layers with 3 perimeters, and a 75% infill for strength. In the clip, you'll see why we're printing off all of the 27 supplied files, but we suspect that you won't be needing or wanting to do that. Perhaps just the one that matches your ratchet or drive handle, or perhaps just the one single socket you've lost or misplaced. You'll note that each of these sockets has the size printed on the barrel, and like commercial sockets, has the appropriate indent on the inside to grasp the ratchet or drive ball bearing. So what does Printable Science use these for? Well, we actually use them quite a bit because many of our projects involve standard nut and bolt sizes to fasten 3D objects together. And if you're familiar with 3D printed threads, you'll know that if you don't use some precaution, the thread will loosen over time, making the joint you've created practically useless. The reason for this is straightforward. An FDM printer isn't all that precise a machine, and the threads it prints are usually pretty rough. So when you thread a bolt into a nut, the friction between the two pieces wears away the roughness, making a better but looser thread. The solution is to print nuts that are a tiny bit larger and bolts that are a tiny bit smaller than the actual size. Or is that the reverse? Anyway, with that approach, you'll find that after you fasten and unfasten the joint a number of times, what was once a very stiff fit settles into a very pleasing joint. So while the demands of our fasteners are such that we use 3D printed nuts and bolts almost exclusively, sometimes the thread fits so tightly when it comes off the printer, it puts too much strain on the plastic parts we've made. To make things easy, we help things along by effectively tapping out our holes and threads after the part is printed. We take the printed part and then using a metal nut or bolt as our die, we then screw and unscrew the part multiple times until the thread fit is what we want. For that application, these sockets work perfectly. Now, it's not much easier to turn a socket with your fingers than a bare nut, and this is where our video on a 3D printed socket driver comes in handy. The link to that project is right here. So we just print off the drive handle we need from the selection of files that are available, and we've taken care of our project post-printing thread treatment needs. If you watch that 3D printed socket driver vid, you'll see we talk about actually gluing a socket onto the end of the driver to give you a dedicated tool for any size that you may use a lot. And that's exactly what we've done at Printable Science, and we have a number of dedicated drivers for the nut and bolt sizes we use the most, at an unbelievably small fraction of the price it would cost us to buy them at the store. So there you have it, sockets and drivers for all your bolt and nut fastening needs. Well, except bridge trusses and cylinder heads. Thanks for watching. And won't you help by becoming an important part of the Printable Science family and making this channel more valuable and successful? You can help us out by taking the time to watch this video in its entirety and other Printable Science videos as well, perhaps while your 3D printer is printing off this project. You can leave comments and questions below. That will help us to continue to create useful videos and 3D STL files that are printer ready and help you to maximize the power and utility of your 3D printer. Your feedback is very important. If you've enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button. And if you have just a moment, won't you show your support by clicking the subscribe button below. If you want to make sure you don't miss our upcoming videos on 3D printing, you'll want to click on the notify bell as well. And please consider supporting Printable Science on Patreon using the link supplied below. You can become one of our Patreon supporters for as little as $1 a month, and it'll provide you with lots of extras and additional information, as well as going a long way to defray the cost of making these files and videos. Down below, you'll also find a link where you can download a copy of the STL files from Thingiverse so that you can print your own socket or socket set. As always, you can download a copy of the STL files for this and other projects directly from our website. The latest files, a discussion board on our socket sets, they're all available at the printablescience.com website, where all the science that fits, we print.